Hey everyone, it's Adam from Grow Education. I'm here today to talk about chickens with you and to introduce you to my friend Josh, who raises chickens at Round the Bend Farm in South Dartmouth. Some of you have met Nate from Round the Bend Farm, who's come in and done some presentations about the farm. So now you get an opportunity to see a video of what it actually looks like at the farm.
Josh Louro. I'm a farmer at Round the Bend Farm in South Dartmouth.
What do you do at Round the Bend Farm?
So I do a bunch of different things. Mainly I'm here to deconstruct some buildings and reclaim and salvage a lot of material from those old buildings. On top of that, we're developing an orchard with apples and pears and a bunch of different fruit. And then this season we started growing vegetables in order to support people in our area.
A mix of turnips and kale and zucchini and summer squash and cucumbers, and a lot more to come is what you guys can see in these what we call flats.
Where are the vegetables going?
Oh, we're going to be distributing them through three different organizations in New Bedford. So it'll go to a number of different families in New Bedford.
Awesome. Can you show us your chickens?
Yeah, definitely. We have 23 chickens in this coop. And we usually let them out, or not usually, we let them out every morning and put them away at night. And we do that because there are a lot of foxes and predators around here. And I think if we left them out at night, there's a high chance that that some foxes would eat them. So we don't want that.
Hey, chickens. So Josh, can you show us a little bit of what it's like? What do you have to do to take care of chickens?
Yeah, of course. To take care of chickens is actually really simple in my perspective. You want to make sure they have food, water, and shelter. And we have shelter here, so we built this coop using a bunch of that old house and barn that we took apart. And then here I have a bucket of water, so I give them fresh water in the morning and at night. And there's a little you can see inside the coop, there's like a little trough that we like to keep in there. And then food, I feed them a mix of things at night. And if you can see them roam around the compost yard, chickens love to scratch and dig for food.
What do chickens eat?
They eat worms, they eat grubs and bugs. They like to forage on grass and seeds, various grains. They're omnivorous, so they eat both meat and plants. So we're gonna show you some of the grasses that they eat. Here is the type of grass that is going to seed, and so this is the part that they haven't eaten. And then if you compare it to the part that they have been foraging on or eating, it looks much different. And this is a part of them eating a mixture of food. So they have bugs and worms and grubs, and they have grasses and seeds, and then we add some other nutrients to help them be more healthy. You got it. So I'm just doing our daily watering. I like to come in here, clean out their old watering thing. It gets kind of dirty. Otherwise, what you see here is bedding. So we like to use old straw for bedding. And that'll get changed every month or two. And so we'll put fresh new straw, so that way they have a comfortable place to live, hopefully.
Josh, can you show us around the chicken home and show us the different parts?
Definitely. So yeah, so we have some netting here, wire, and we want to keep that a part of the whole chicken coop to keep out those predatory animals like foxes and hawks and coyotes. And we also want to have this here to allow some air circulation and ventilation. And so that's this kind of front third of the chicken coop. And what you'll see in the back two thirds is a number of different elements. And so we have some old metal roofing as a side to prevent rain and heavy, like intense weather from getting in. And then these pieces of wood on the chicken coop are what we call roosts. And so chickens, from what I understand, like to sleep up on these. So at night, when we come in here, you can see them all perched up and sleeping on their roosts. And then towards the back, there's the laying boxes. We have five of them here, and you can see a bunch of delicious eggs that were laid this morning that we'll collect soon.
Here we're gonna collect some eggs this morning, which we like to do in the early morning time, or actually mid-morning, sorry. And we built this laying box, which is what you saw on the inside, on the outside, so that way we don't have to walk inside their home, their chicken coop, if we don't need to. And so this is on a hinge, and we can lift it up. And if you see inside here, there's a little chicken right here, actually. Oh. So this is where she lays, so we might be disturbing her laying right now. But it's okay. And then the rest of these laying boxes, you can see a number of eggs. And so we'll collect them and store them at an even temperature. And so eggs freshly collected don't need to be refrigerated. So they don't need to be refrigerated, and they'll last a long time if you care for them properly. And yeah.
Why do eggs in the grocery store need to be refrigerated?
So eggs in the grocery store need to be refrigerated because they typically wash the eggs. And so there's a coating when a chicken lays an egg that preserves the egg. It keeps it viable or help, like it keeps it edible for a long time. And so in the store, they wash that. They wash that off for a number of different reasons. And once you wash that coating off, you have to then keep it refrigerated. So here we have a compost pile. A compost pile can be made up of a bunch of different material. This compost pile is made up of horse manure, I believe some cow manure, now chicken manure, which manure is their poop or pee, in case you didn't know. And a bunch of other yard debris, whether leaf clippings or sticks and twigs and grass clippings. And they're scratching for all the little grubs and worms that help break down all of that material to eventually create healthy soil. And so these chickens are helping us break down this material to create healthy soil, which then creates healthier chickens, which has healthier eggs.
So Josh, if you sell your eggs in New Bedford, how far are the eggs traveling from the chicken to the plate of whoever's eating it?
Good question. So our eggs are traveling no more than 10 miles from where they are raised and laid here to where they will end up hopefully in someone's belly.
And if you buy eggs at the grocery store, do you always know where they're coming from?
No, you don't. Typically, those eggs are coming from a bunch of different farms all across the country, so they could come anywhere from thousands of miles away to hundreds of miles away. It's hard to tell.
So would you say your eggs are more sustainable if you're eating them from your local farm?
Yes, yeah. I think it feels that sustainability is knowing in part where your farmer and where your food's coming from, and knowing that these chickens are, again, no more than 10 miles from New Bedford to where they'll be eaten, I believe is sustainable, yeah.
In the wintertime, do chickens produce as many eggs in the summertime?
No, they don't. The chickens in the wintertime will lay much less eggs. Now, these 23 chickens probably lay 75% of them lay an egg a day. In the wintertime, I'm guessing that'll be half or less than that. And that has to do with how much they're moving around, that has to do with the temperature outside, that has to do with a bunch of different factors.
So Josh, what have you learned being a farmer?
For me, I've learned that farming is about building and developing a relationship with nature. And so my role as a farmer is to support the health of the chickens, the health of the soil, the health of the grass, the health of the trees in order to help feed people.
Here you guys see some of Round the Bend's cattle. And what we were talking about earlier with the chicken coop, having it be on wheels would allow us to move that chicken coop behind the cattle once they're done on a certain section of pasture. And they'll scratch through all the manure and poop and spread all of that fertility in order to have healthier grass and soil.
So, for the really important question, what came first, the chicken or the egg?
Only she knows the answer.
fresh from the evening, dreaming about all the homies I believe in. I have so much time to think. I got sisters who are mothers and brothers who are fathers to me.